beautiful. I think even for the artists, they're learning a lot from the material of other artists as well. And I love abstract art, so to be part of the show is just really exciting. And my work, I work in acrylic. I work both in canvas, and there's a piece over there behind us there, and that's also on paper. I love working with acrylic because it's very versatile. You can work with it very opaque, and you can have some light washes as well. There are so many of the things that all the other artists said about abstraction and why it's so interesting and challenging and inspirational. It's because it's really much, very much an internal process for me as well. And the way I work, I really don't have a plan when I start the piece. It's quite chaotic in the beginning. We start with a lot of line work and very loose drawing. It could be a very loose landscape drawing or still life or shapes, and make it quite chaotic in the beginning, and then try and find some order in it and create layers with color, balance with darks and lights, and step back, look at it, and it's very much a process until you kind of come at the end. Sometimes I'll work with very limited colors to make it more challenging. Like that piece has only three colors, and everything else is mixed, so that it's much more challenging and interesting to find the end or the final piece. I'm originally from East Africa, from Eritrea, so I'm also really interested in script and writing, and some of the pieces have the alphabet from Ethiopia and Eritrea in there, and use that as a design and abstract basis for the line work as well. So that piece has some of the alphabet in it, and so does that one, but sort of abstracted so that you can also just make it look lyrical, and it can work as if you recognize the letters or even if you don't. Like I said, I mean, even this one has some of the line work of the letters underneath as an underpainting, and but slowly abstracting into something else in the end. So it's a very internal process, like I said. It's, you really do paint for yourself, but oftentimes, as you can see from all this work, I think we all connect to a lot of these pieces, even though it's not us who created it, but there's something universal about some of these pieces that we all kind of connect to, and I think that's what's exciting, and that the viewer and the painter have a sort of relationship. What somebody sees in these pieces is going to be different from what I see, but at some point we all connect, and I think that's what's really beautiful about abstract.
Are there any questions of Elsa or any of the other artists?
I actually have. Was there anything different about the process in creating this one?
In the process, no. I really, in the beginning of all the pieces, there are just really line work. It's very chaotic, like I said. In fact, it's quite scary in the beginning because it really looks like a mess. But by really trying to simplify and simplify and simplify, you sort of eliminate a lot of that chaos to try and find a little bit more calm and order. And it's, like you said, like a lot of you said, it's very meditative, I think. So because you're concentrating and you're really stepping back, turning it around. I work with it upside down, sideways, and really, push the way you look at something. And I think a lot of the artists here do the same thing. So. Pretty much
this. And did you work pretty much, I don't know if we haven't talked about this yet, but not pre-sketch anything, just pretty much the moment?
Yes, I mean, what I'll do, so I do work in series, so if there's an idea that I'm exploring, like the writing, like the script, you know, then I'll have a number of pieces that explore the text and the writing in different formats. Just keep doing a number of pieces within that format. This one is called, for example, Vessels. And if it's, if you kind of, it's very loose underpainting of vases, you know? And so there's a series of those as well. And we're all like containers. We have memories, and this one actually is called Holding Memories. And it's like that. It's like our brains are, you know, our minds are like a vessel. We hold a lot of memories, we hold a lot of experiences, our past, you know, things that we see also can be metaphors for our lives. And I think that's, you know, you may not see that initially, you know, because it's really abstracted in there.
But once you said it, it's clear as that.
Exactly. But, you know, you don't have, you know, this. It's nice not to know, and it's nice to know. It works either way. So, some are, you know, I think that's part of what is beautiful about abstract.
And I like the fact that you use the symbols and to the lettering, which is really the basis of a lot of modern and abstract art, using ancient hieroglyphics and African art forms, ideologies, Native American symbols, cosmology. So that's part of what drew me to your work when you included the show.
Because I think, you know, writing is a lot about communicating. It's amazing that there are so many cultures that we have so many languages, and the lettering itself is beautiful. Like you said, hieroglyphics, Asian languages, so many other languages, that the lettering itself, like, it's just beautiful to look at. And that piece, for example, I also like to use texture, and so beads and, you know, other texture medium, like some of the other artists like to use too, because that's very, to me also is very African, the colors as well. So, you know, some of those, some of my pieces also do incorporate some of that textural elements.
Thank you.